All right, it's recording. I have to trust that it's actually really recording. So for some reason, I was incapable of finding the right way to install the NVIDIA driver on Fedora 29. The bad thing is, as you can see, I'm really pretty bad here because I'm on GNOME. Oh, holy moly, GNOME is a nightmare. Why? I mean, just if you want to have a laugh, open up the file manager here. No information. You don't know any information how much space is left. It doesn't show you anything. It is. I don't know what these people, if they are thinking, I have no idea what is going on. I do not know. So what I did, I followed the link Sergi gave me. Where is it? Where's my studio? Oh, yeah, here. So he said he's busy with his stuff. Film Wasteland is soon a good Linux user, so I don't have any problems with that. He's very soon converted. So here's what I got. Hello, Dirk, try this. By the way, you deserve your issues with NVIDIA. he's a brutal man, I tell you. But however, he's capable of finding the proper links. I tried different links that didn't work. So I will put in this video that link. And I think one of the keys, most important parts, is that this here explains, it actually lets you uninstall. Here's the echo, didn't work for me, so I had to go with Nano in and added the Blacklist Nouveau and stuff like that. And here, it removes the Nouveau driver. So with that, of course, it can't interfere anymore. My other subscriber, he does, where is it? I have to go back. Is him. And he said I should just .org. So that's what I usually do. You know, I do that very often. I just go in and rename these files to make sure they don't interfere anymore. But I thought before I start tinkering, because I spared you my tinkering in the last video, I really spared it, because it is a nightmare for me. No, I mean, not a nightmare. I tinker around my typical way. Why do I not get my channel? No. Prepaid, can you imagine paid membership? What the heck? I mean, where are we here now? Huh? Dang, this is not to make money. However, as you can see, or as you couldn't, NVIDIA, look at this. So the link Sergi gave me worked just fine. If you can follow instruction, that's the way to go. Funny thing is, I have a word of thanks here. And I installed it. If I wouldn't have been banned for 1 day and a half, I killed a team killer. Wargaming's logic means I have to be punished for this. You cannot kill a team killer. That guy wanted to push me off a cliff. So I shot him dead. A few shots and he was done. And I was banned, which wasn't a big deal because I had to leave anyway. No time the whole night for playing. Today, I think at 2 o'clock, so in 2.5 hours, 2 hours 40 minutes, I should be able to play it, so then I can see what the performance does on Fedora. So now, except that I have a desktop environment I really do not want, that makes a bad, it is a nightmare. I mean, Fedora, what the heck, why are you on GNOME? Cutting a long story short, I can't say anything about the performance just yet. I mean, yes, it works. I could not get VLC, and I've got RPM fusions on. I could not get VLC, I could not get Simple Screen Recorder, I could not get OBS. So I found that extension, Screen Recorder extension, so that helped me to screen record here. Oh, let me see if I can get at least VirtualBox. I hope it works. VirtualBox. Of course, VirtualBox client. Of course not. Man, I mean, really, really. Yes, I know they work with their, what is that called? GNOME boxes or boxes. But what the heck, people? I mean, man, really? So Fedora, I mean, I try it again. Maybe, hold on, where are the sources? Can't even get in. What the heck? How do I see the sources? I think I can't, right? What is that doing? Ooh, multifunction, okay. Nope. So it seems they don't want to have it easy. Let me see, RPM Fusion for Fedora 29. So let me see where it is. Graphical setup for what? First enable access free repository for users of GPKey, GNOME package kit and Kubernetes. Once that succeeded, you can enable access to non-free repository. So you have to first enable access, okay. Once that succeeded, you can non-free. Is that really to enable access to both the free and non-free repository, you use the following command. Silverblue 29 later. Okay. You have to reboot for RPM Fusion repositories to appear. So, it's a little bit... We have two separate software repositories, free and non-free. And it's not open source. First command line said I'm using RPM. Okay, so does that mean... Oh dear me, that is terrible, isn't it? Can I enlarge it? Oh yeah, at least I can see something. So they go, first you do the non-free, no, the free. See, I'm the lazy guy. I do copy and paste. Sudo dnf install. Does it find it like this? Yeah, it did. Okay, one done. And then I go for that one. Maybe then I get my VLC player. And my VirtualBox, that would be nice. If that's all, I mean, the thing is, Fedora is for sure not for Film Wasteland. You know, he's going to convert to Linux very soon, or to BSD. So, but that's happening very soon. And the other guy, what is his name? So we have two Windows users which are ready for any moment to jump on the Linux train, and that is Film Wasteland. And there's another guy, Windows enthusiast. So yeah, these two, they're really keen on getting onto Linux. I mean, I have a cold, so you see my voice is pear-shaped. They're really keen to get on the Linux train, and I really welcome them back to the, or not back, but welcome them to the Linux community. They really, really want to do it. And I'm very happy that they do it. So yeah, and Fedora, I think they can do it. So all you have to do is follow the... Yeah, and I will put that on. I will upload that before I reboot the computer. Because I have to reboot to get the RPM, the Fusion, working. And the repo. And then I will put Sergi's link there, because that works. It works. It works. If you follow these instructions, print them off, because you have to reboot and do some target stuff, enabling and disabling, which is not too much. It's actually very easy to do if it works. The one I found just didn't work. I couldn't find a proper link where it really worked. Thank you, Sergi. Really good. So now we'll see with RPM Fusion. If I get my VirtualBox, if I can get my VLC, maybe Simple Screen Recorder. That recorder seems to be doing okay too. So that wouldn't be a big deal. Yeah. So, Sergi, thank you so much for caring for me here, for the channel. And maybe I have to make a more detailed video. But on the end, honestly, if you just follow these steps, step by step, it works. Yeah. I mean, I went to the NVIDIA website and let them, you can search for a driver. You know, you say the model you have, the version you have, and then it finds the driver for you. That's what I did. And that worked fine. I'm very sure that this works too. So either way, it will work. Don't you worry about a thing. So, however, it works. I could install. That's another thing. Why can I install WhisPlayer on Linux, World of Tanks, so easily on Calculate Linux? Yeah, Fedora now. Xubuntu, it worked. MX has huge. No, MX 17.1, yeah, now works. Hold on, yeah. 18 seems to have trouble with the NVIDIA graphic card installer. So just use the 17.1 version, install it, and install it from there, your NVIDIA driver cards, because I think it's a better way. Or, yeah, so I would say go for that. So now MX 17.1, Calculate Linux, and which is Gen 2 based, and now Fedora. Let me install World of Tanks totally easy in the 64-bit Wine prefix. I don't know why it doesn't work on Magia in a moment. I mean, I'm in a 2 beta. 6 doesn't boot. I have no clue why. Doesn't want to boot. Doesn't do it. 5 was great. 5.1 was great. 6, that's where we separated because that was when I had trouble installing World of Tanks. No, I can't wait to get Magia 7 back to work. That would be very interesting. But now look at this. You can actually install Fedora. And I think I keep Fedora too. Because I saw videos where people say, oh, it's now so stable. Before it was more the testing platform. And people said, you know what, when the new Fedora comes out, wait 2 months and then install it. Because then the most little things are fixed. And I wonder if I have any issues at all. I installed my HP printer, here it is, and my printers, of course, totally no problem. Takes a little moment. I printed already something off, so I know it works. Yep, the RAND, there it is. Status, supplies, it works. Oh, let's see if I can get Gscan to PDF. Gscan to PDF. That doesn't look good, no? So let's see. I have to upload this video. But I will upload it after reboot, because then I can play around while it's uploading. Okay, guys. So you click here on it, and then you can say stop recording, and I see you soon, guys. So again, Sergi, thank you so much for the rescue. Now I just have to work out how to get XFCE properly on. The XFCE spin didn't want it to boot up. So if I can make it work here to get XFCE working, then this becomes a maybe good operating system. Let's see. However, thank you so much, Sergi. Oh, system tray detected on this. Unable to start, exit. Yeah, okay. Doesn't matter. Don't need it. Okay, guys. Thank you for watching. Stay tuned. There's more stuff coming. I wanted to do Fedora for so long, but it could not work on my Optimus laptop. Now it's different. Okie dokie. Bye, 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 bye.